So in this video, we're going to look at this project from a lighting perspective. This project was done a while back, probably almost like 2 years ago now. But it's still a great project to look at from a lighting perspective and how you get lights like a lighting scene like this. So one, a big thing to look at is how I've only used very soft lights to kind of get a very, I don't know what the right word is, but the watch looks very shiny and very kind of, I don't want to say premium, but like just like more shiny, softer, and just looks more delicate. Like you can swap out these words whatever you want, but here you can see there's a lot of gradients going on, which adds some nice contrast. Here's a gradient, so it goes black, white, black, same here, black, white, dark, and then lights to dark, lights to dark, and all these very soft lights really create a very nice contrasty image as opposed to it looking very flat. And yeah, I thought I would break it down. So here I'm doing everything inside of HDR Light Studio just so I'm not swapping windows the whole time. But if we start from the ground up, because one is just showing how all I'm using is very soft lights, but where am I placing these lights and why? That's also very important. So generally with watches, with watches, you kind of want to look at what the features are. So usually I break them down to parts. So there's the two straps, then there's the middle part, or this middle section here. There's these little pins, there's this top face here, and then there's this area and that area. I don't know the exact words for them. And then there's these sides, and that's usually where I put my lights and try and illuminate each area. So here there's the straps. Here you can see we've got a light over there. Usually I'll have a light for the side. Here I'll usually have a light on this pin and that pin. That'll add some nice gradients here. And then here you can see there's a middle light going on there. Then there's two lights emphasizing this area, and it's basically feature-based lighting, which I've gone over in past tutorial. But here you can see how it's applied in a very light scene. So if we start from black, you can see how these lights are put together, and then you'll kind of get an idea of how you can apply this to your scenes and get a scene that looks similar to this. So inside of HDR Light Studio, it takes a little bit of time to update, but where do we start? So here we've got a light for our top rim. Boom. So just lighting up the features. So if I've got a light on the top, I'm usually like to be symmetrical and also have a light on the bottom. So top rim light's on. Then we need our bottom rim light, which might be this one. I don't name these the best. Top rim face light. Okay, we don't have to go in specific order, but we got a light for our top rim, one for the face, one for the rim light on the side here, and you can see how these nice soft lights, you can also create these with area lights inside of Octane, but I prefer to do this in HDR Light Studio just because, the lighting quality is usually better, and you can see how the lighting quality shines through this render versus if I try to do this with area lights in Octane. As I said, you don't have to use this program, but for high quality of light, I like to do that. So I'm trying to look for this light here. That's not it. Side fill. So here is our light for the bottom. Starts to eliminate like the different features. So you see we've got lights that's showing the top here, as well as lighting that. We've got lights that's showing the bottom here. And then here we need lights for this strap section here. So if we turn this light off and we look at what's missing, which areas are still dark, which areas still need detail and light. We need to light up this area, and these areas up here, and then also along the side here, and maybe up there as well. And all we're doing is just trying to bring out detail, and I'll usually put like gradient lights, like a light from that edge to this edge, so going from lighter to darker to add in some contrast. So here I'm thinking a light going from lights to dark, same here, maybe lights to dark or the other way around, and then here ideally a gradient as well. So if we turn this one on, you'll see that we've got a light placed more at the bottom of these straps, and then it goes from gradients from lights to dark. We also want one on the top here. So if you go to the top strap fill, you'll see that we've got gradients going from light to dark here as well. Ideally, going from like light to dark. And as I said, what gradients do is add in contrast. So here, this edge is still a little bit dark. Don't have to light and add a light here, but I probably would add just a little bit of a gradient light there. And then all that's left is just these sides here. This side here is still left in black. So we're gonna add in lights there. So if we go add in one light, it'll light up one of the crowns. Boom, adds detail to this side. And then adds detail to this side, and then I'll see if maybe I placed a light on this side, which might be the side fill here. Not sure if it is. Nope, isn't that. But this is how I go about putting lights together. It's like starting off in blackness, looking at which features. So this one is the big one, the top face, these edges here, then you work down, okay, like the strap, the two straps, and then the sides, and then you end up with a render like this. And with all the soft lights, you get some nice contrast versus if these were like very hard edge lights, you might not get as much contrast, or if a lot of these lights were just flat. And even if you had like a background like this that was kind of like a middle grayish, you'll see how this render starts to look a little bit more washed out. Here things start to look more flat, and I've seen this a lot in people's renders where this kind of looks a little bit more washed out and not as contrasted. So that's how this was put together from a lighting perspective. Hopefully this helps you with your renders and your lighting, and helps put your renders together a bit more professionally. Hope that helped, and I'll see you in the next video.